In the previous video, we trained our logistic regression classifier. Let's now go ahead and evaluate its performance. And for that, we still have to add this threshold function to obtain the class labels from the probability scores. So the probability scores are values between 0 and 1. Here, these are the probability scores for the last mini batch. So here we are being lazy and we are just keeping these probability scores from the last mini batch. But of course, we also want to generalize that to apply it to the whole data set. So in PyTorch, there is this .where function that we can use to threshold these values. We can say if the probability score is greater than 0.5, return class label 1, and otherwise return class label 0. So this way, we can turn these probability scores into class labels. So here, this would be the label array for the last mini batch. So that we can view it side by side, let's now reshape our class label array, which is a rank 1 tensor, into this column tensor, which has two dimensions. So for that, we use .view and use the shape of this prediction array. And then we also transfer this class label array to the same data type as the prediction array. So here now we can compare the predicted labels here to the actual class labels. And based on that, we can compute the accuracy of the model. Our accuracy function here looks a little bit more complicated than before because there are a few extra steps. So I recommend for evaluation to put the model into the evaluation mode via .eval. So this is very similar to what we did in the training when we set model.train. Then, similar to before, we keep track of the number of correct predictions. And here we also compute the total number of examples. So then we iterate over a data loader here. And for each iteration, for each mini batch, what we do is we compute the probabilities, threshold the probabilities just as before, get the class labels as we've seen previously, and compare actual class labels to the predicted class labels. Then this will return a tensor of true and false. So in Python, we can actually use the int function to convert a Boolean value, for example, true, into an integer value here. Similarly, a false would return a 0. This way, we can actually compute the sum of all the true values in a list or in an array like this. So in this case, this should return 2. And using the same concept, we are using torch sum here to sum up all the correct predictions. So all cases where lab is equal to pred. So that means the true label is equal to the predicted label. We are adding this number then to the count here, the correct count, and we also increment the total number of examples. And then finally, to compute the accuracy, we divide the number of correct predictions by the total number of examples. So then, after we implemented this function, we can actually use it and take a look at the accuracy of our logistic regression classifier. So in this case, it's a logistic regression classifier with an accuracy of 100%, which is actually great. But again, this is a very simple data set, and in many real-world cases, we will encounter data sets that are more challenging. So we will also have optional exercises for you where you can actually try this out on different data sets. Now, for the last part here, let's also take a quick look at the decision boundary. So just to see how the logistic regression classifier looks like for this two-dimensional data set. The code here is actually the same that we used in Unit 1 and Unit 2, so we are not going over this again in detail. We are just visualizing the data set here again, and then plotting the boundary. So here, this is really exactly the same as the code that we used in the previous units, except now we are getting the model weights from linear, and we do the same thing here for the bias unit. So we can see now that the logistic regression classifier nicely classifies all the orange triangles correctly and also all the blue diamonds correctly. So this is a logistic regression classifier implemented in PyTorch. Of course, it might seem overkill because other libraries implement logistic regression as well, but we will build on these concepts later on when we implement deep neural networks.